Hey guys, welcome to Hops and Brews. I'm John. Today we're going to be reviewing Stickmann Brewing's Bananas on Fire Dunkelweizen. So like I said before, we're going to be reviewing Oregon's own Stickmann Brewing Company, Bananas on Fire Dunkelweizen. This beer comes in at a 7.6% ABV, a 17 IBU, it gets an average rating of 3.70 on Untappd. Stickmann Brewing is located in Lake Oswego, Oregon. The description on this beer states, an ode to Bananas Foster via a double Dunkelweizen. The Vine Hestefan's Weizen yeast provides banana and spice, while the caramel comes from a good dose of specialty malt. Vanilla in the secondary rounds out the classic flavor profile. Right away, it looks like a Mars, and it looks like a German style of beer, very caramely, very dark, very creamy looking head. Smells very banana-y, ester, spice, you know, very German style. Ooh, yeah. I mean, this just tastes like, wow, a really good Marzen. Not really a Dunkelweizen, but I mean, Marzens and Dunkelweizens, they're very similar in a lot of characteristics. Best way I can describe it is malty, Oktoberfest-y, very little hops. You get this banana esters from a yeast. Not really necessarily like artificial banana flavors like Laffy Taffy or anything like that, but this yeasty German style banana esters. Not a whole lot of vanilla like it talked about. Honestly, I was expecting a bit more from this, and it was imperial and it's banana, so I was expecting this big punch. Right now, it's just tasting good. And so far, I'm actually really enjoying it. I really like a really good German-style beer. And by what I mean by German, I mean gives it that really banana-y esters, those sweet spice notes in the yeast. I really enjoy those. This actually tastes a lot like that. I'm tasting a little bit more of the alcohol, which isn't too bad. It's not overpowering. It's just enough to just slightly know it's there. But it's still really good tasting. What I found interesting is that aerating your sips give you way more of this banana flavor than what is described, or just drinking it. Kind of all, and there's just lots of banana, and you kind of do get that banana-y, Laffy Taffy kind of flavor to it. I still think that this would be really good with a sausage. Honestly, I really want one right now. I'm kind of hungry. Does it taste like Bananas Foster's? Like the can states? No, it does not taste like that. Honestly, when I see something like that and it states that on the can, I'm kind of thinking it's going to be Great Notion style, super sweet, you know, artificial flavoring. I kind of almost wish it was like that. If it just didn't say that and said Bananas on Fire Imperial Dunkelweizen, I'd be like, dude, this hit it. It nailed it. But because it states that on the can, I got a ding and a point. But so far, I'm still digging this beer. Very enjoyable. So we're coming up at the end of this beer. Honestly, been enjoying it. Just tastes like a really good German Dunkelweizen. Probably just what's missing in this, and really it's probably just the water that was used for this. Just a little more minerals in it, hardening that water. Boom, this would have been spot on. That's the only thing missing from this beer. Other than that, I've been really enjoying it. As it got down to the bottom, really enjoyed the aroma because it just starts popping out. That banana ester, those malty notes, honestly. It's great. I really enjoy that. Well, the label was actually the thing that caught me. I was at the register and I saw the label. It was an impulse purchase and that's what really got me. So I really like that. Again, though, the downside is that the label does state Banana Foster Ale. That's what got me. I'm not tasting that. I do taste banana from the yeast, but it's not a Banana's Foster Ale. So, that's the ding. So, but if you do find yourself in the Portland, Oregon area, see if you can pick one of these up. It's a fantastic beer if you like the German style of beers. This is not your typical Northwest style German style beer. This will be a bit more traditional. Again though, a little bit weak in the body. But flavor wise, it's probably going to be spot on for you. But everyone has their own taste. This one's just agreeing with me. I'm going to go 8 for this. I was going to say 8 shit. Did I just say 8 shits? 8 shit. It's got a good taste, though. Cheers, guys. Bananas in pajamas. Something, something. Bananas on fire. Hey guys, I'm Joe. Welcome to Hops and Brews. Today we're going to be reviewing Stickman Brewing's Bananas on Fire. Just imagine there's special effects right here, but probably not going to happen because I'm too lazy in post. Bananas and pajamas are coming all the way. I think that's the key to beer. Clever name, decent artwork, okay beer. You'll make money. At least it wasn't canned conditioned.